Welcome to Real Food, everybody. Fun show today. Joining me is Frank Genovas. Now, he's from Francesco's of Babylon, a place I've been going to for like, it seems like 30-something years. I've been there a long time. Serves all kinds of wonderful food, a lot of Southern Italian specialties from 1979. So there you go. When I was graduating high school, that place was opening up. And also joining us today, a real good friend of mine, Angie Carpenter, who is presently Islip Town Supervisor, but has played many roles in the Long Island community. It's great to have you.
Thank you so much.
And you've also been like a good friend to the church, a good friend to me here at Catholic Faith Network, so thanks for
all that. Well, you're easy to be a good friend
to. We know each other a long time.
A long time.
All of us know each other a long time. It's good to see you, Frank. Thanks.
Best customer.
Thanks
for being here. Yeah, Frank's in the neighborhood. It's all great.
Thank you. It's amazing.
Great.
So, Frank, I can remember like being really a young priest, and you were a younger guy. We were all younger a bunch of years ago. But, I mean, you were at that restaurant, at that location for a number of years, right? I mean, you have other places, too, that you've had, right?
1979. I graduated high school and I bought the place. My father helped me out.
Oh, that's awesome.
And my mother helped me cook and that was it. She would wait tables, go in the back and cook and wait tables back and forth, and I would be in the front.
And it kind of started out, I mean, if I remember back, way back, it was like one of those classic Italian places where there was like pizza in one store, but then the restaurant in the other store, right?
Yeah, and it was the back.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then we expanded once.
Right.
And then we had the fire, and then we expanded the third time, and then it's three stores more.
Three stores now, right? Wow, that's incredible.
Yeah, yeah.
And the place is just buzzing all the time. I love that. I mean, it's a busy place, right?
It is. It is. It's kind of, you have the bar in the front, and people have dinner at the bar and gather and visit in a lovely, lovely environment.
And good food and all of that, high-quality food. Yeah. I love that. Yeah. Your kids went to St. John the Baptist, right?
Yep.
So, like, you've been involved with the church.
Lady of Lourdes first, and St. John's.
Yeah, and then you're always helping out the Catholic Church in a zillion different ways. I know it's like sort of nonstop.
Yeah, and people I went to a Catholic school in Queens, St. Pius III.
Oh, wow, okay.
And
that's cool. So it's got a long history of this stuff, right?
Yeah.
That's cool. And I know you come up with different recipes. Like, I love the fact that, like, when I go there, because the times I have been there, you'll bring out a little dish or something and say, try this. This is something totally different.
Yes, absolutely.
So, like, I mean, you have something, like, a little different you're making today? Is that the story?
You know, we have the basic Italian. I know you like to cook the pasta and all the basic Italian food, but we sometimes we do a little sushi. We'll do a little Asian.
Isn't that interesting?
You know, we'll do things that are just a little creative. You know, my chefs, we always concoct something. So.
Something interesting and something different.
So today we're gonna do a lot of Long Island. It's a lot of Long Island produce because we do buy Long Island produce.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, the truck comes and just, you know, this time of the year.
Yeah.
And we're gonna do spaghetti squash.
Wow. Okay.
Which is a very popular dish, and a lot of customers are asking how do you make it.
It's one of my favorites.
So now they can see how we make it.
The secret is being made.
And it's so we're gonna do a lot of Long Island vegetables, and then we're gonna do a swordfish, which is caught in Long Island.
Okay.
You know, so everything Long Island.
I want my favorite
Long Island
fish.
Food, Long Island people, Long Island guy. You know.
All right.
It's our story of our lives. All right, you get started. Let me talk to Angie for a second.
Okay.
So I know, Angie, like, how many years of public service for you? I mean, my gosh, it's
26.
26
this
years.
This year is 26 years.
And the roles you played, I remember, like, when you were in the legislature, I was a younger priest then myself.
Yes, yes. You came and did many invocations at the legislature for us.
Suffolk County Legislature. Suffolk County here in New York, where we were.
Yeah, I was there nearly 13 years. And then served as the county's treasurer for 9.
Okay.
And then when the supervisor that was there before me, Tom Croce, was elected to be the senator, there was a vacancy and they asked if I would come. So I left the office of treasurer and came to be the supervisor and then ran for election that November for my first full term.
Right.
And I absolutely love it. It's an incredible town. The employees, it's really a sense of family.
It's a wonderful thing.
And, you know, I say that Islip Town's the third largest town in the state of New York, but there's still that hometown feeling, you
know,
wonderful restaurants around and the beaches, and we have an airport, you know.
That's true, right? Islip MacArthur, which we all know, right?
And a lot of good things are happening there. You know, we're adding flights, and we added Frontier Airlines, and...
And you do a radio show from the radio station located there, right?
Yeah, there's a radio station at the airport, and I do a show every other week, and then we put it on our local access channel, the government access channel, and it gives people an opportunity to hear someone, you know, conversationally talking about what they do. We have all kinds of, we've had you on the show.
I've been a happy participant, And then together, we were on the Our Lady of Consolation board together.
Yes.
Then we went on the Continuing Care board together.
Continuing Care
and
board.
And you chaired that
and
for the Catholic Church.
And then you abandoned me.
And then you had to take on your own, I'm sorry. And how many years, you've done that?
It's got to be 30 years.
30 years.
More than 30 years. I was, you know, had business in the community, very involved in the community, the chamber, et cetera. And a number of people reached out and asked if I would come be on the board of Our Lady of Consolation. And a 450-bed skilled nursing and geriatric care facility. It's been downsized a little bit. The one wing of it, the north wing of it, is going to, in fact, that opening is happening and will have happened by the time we're watching this. Yeah. But a state-of-the-art cancer treatment center right on the campus there of Good Samaritan Hospital and Our Lady of Consolation.
Yeah, this is great. So, like, your generosity to the Catholic Church is renowned also. So, well, you know, it's like a good partnership all around. That's why all these friends today, it's sort of where we are. Like, all these people who've been involved in the church, but also involved in the local community, which is nice. So, now, what did you get going here? I see you got some garlic chopped up. You got some shrimp going.
Garlic, yep, and this is
that's the store.
Spaghetti. This is it's really hard to cut it, so you got to be very careful.
Show us how you do it, because I'll tell you I'm sort of scared of spaghetti squash.
Yeah, the easiest way is to just to poke.
Give it a stab. That's
Yeah, give it a poke and then poke it through, and then get two halves. It's the most safest way.
Frank, they're always talking about this tastes just like spaghetti, and it's not. It doesn't taste like spaghetti. But it's got its own flavor, right?
Yeah, but if you spice it right.
I'm waiting to try
it. It's kind of benign. It takes on the flavor of what you put on it.
Yeah.
So when you put sauce.
It's
I mean, these are the people. Like the people who tell me, the whole wheat pasta. Well, the whole wheat pasta tastes like whole wheat pasta.
No.
And it's okay. You know? It's all right. I'm not against it, but.
So you put it in a pan. You put it in a pan flat.
Oh, see, look at that. That's interesting.
You know, down.
Okay.
And then when it's cooked, this is what it looks like when it comes out.
Wow, that's
interesting. And you let it cool off.
Okay.
You let it cool off.
And then you put a little olive oil on there?
Olive oil on the bottom, yeah. So it's about an hour. It's about an hour, about 350, 400 degrees.
Oh, wow, so it takes a bit.
So you take the seeds out.
Is this available year-round, like spaghetti squash?
Yeah, sure.
It is?
Oh, so that's interesting. So you don't seed it before you cook it.
Yeah, right. You seed it after it's done.
Yes. Yeah, the olive oil.
And then that's really soft. And this here is really hard, everybody. It's sort of like, you know, like, I don't know, hard, like a almost gourdy hard.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like a gourd.
But it becomes a spaghetti when you peel it.
That's the part I want to see, how you get to the spaghetti part of all of this.
So
this
is interesting. Throw some garlic in here.
Right off the bat, it's going to taste good with like some garlic and oil and everything. It makes everything better.
I see a big bowl of basil. How bad can that be?
Yeah, that can't be bad. Okay. And some spinach, right? So this is all good.
So I'm going to rush it a little bit here. So
you're going with a spoon, huh?
Yeah, you're going to loosen it up.
Interesting.
In the restaurant, we loosen them up just before the dinner hour. Once you loosen up, you're going to put it right back in here when you're done.
Is that how you go? Really?
Yeah, sure.
Wow, look at this. This is interesting. So it's not like you're not shredding
it's empty.
Though. So it doesn't shred it. I thought you shred it. So.
No. It's just a perfect shell.
That's amazing.
You could put it on a plate when after you saute, or you could put it right back in it, and then maybe an hour, half hour later, whenever you want. You could pop them in the oven when everybody gets home, and you could serve it as a dinner.
Serve it like that, wow. Mm. You know, Frank, another thing about your restaurant, and I know it's kind of hard to talk about, but it's the truth of the matter, is that a lot of people choose to go there for lunch after the funeral of a loved one, which is interesting.
Yes,
because I, sadly have to do a lot of funerals as a priest. But I know a lot of times people will say, well, going back to Francesco's for lunch, would you like to come? Which I think is a nice thing. Like you try to really accommodate the local families who've been coming to you for years, right?
And
that's a nice thing that you do that,
Thank you.
Because that's one of the times I was there. I had a dear friend, Maria Sigliano, who you knew too.
Oh, yeah.
And after her, she left in her will that she wanted everybody to have lunch at Francesco's, which is nice.
Yes.
So some shrimp went in with it.
It went shrimp and sun-dried tomatoes.
Sun-dried tomatoes, that's beautiful.
Do a little chopped spinach.
So chopped spinach. Mm. Now, would you have this all the time? Is this a special, Frank? What do you do?
This is on our special menu for a while now because we can't take it off. Just everybody
people
wants
like it so
it.
Much.
Yeah, we'll change it up a little bit.
Now I'm really interested. I got to tell you, I'm really interested in this. Have you had it? You've had
I
this?
Order it almost every time I go there.
You love it?
Yeah. I did once on a fluke. Just wanted to be healthy.
Yeah, try something different.
But it is so delicious.
And then,
now, Angie, how many years are you married to Joe?
55.
50. That's
55
awesome.
Years. I can't believe it.
And two kids grown?
Yep. Two kids grown, grandkids. I have my granddaughter, Sydney, who's 17, a senior at Bayshore High School. And my grandson, Joe, who's 6. He's in first grade at Timber Point Elementary. Yeah,
but
great.
Sydney, I baptized Sydney. I don't like hearing that she's a senior. It seemed like I baptized her yesterday.
I know. It's just gone so quickly.
It's fun to get old. Not really. So now purple...
local purple cauliflower.
That's amazing, too. Nice.
Yeah, isn't that pretty?
I mean, so the colors of this dish is also
amazing.
Really amazing, right?
Yeah.
And if you think about it, what is really the flavors of this is the food. You're not adding brown gravy to this or
right.
anything.
It's, no. this right. is it's the garlic oil base,
yeah.
good olive oil, and then your spices. And you have to have enough, you know, pepper and salt. Pepper. I'm using regular ground pepper and Himalayan salt.
Amazing like this. It's terrific. Now, Frank, you know, one of your hobbies, I know, as I knew you over the years, was fishing. Are you
yeah.
still fishing and stuff? Or what?
Yes, I still fish. Yeah.
You still like to fish?
Yes.
And I think that's how you develop a lot of recipes, right? You're able
sure,
to kind of
sure.
think
well,
about saying, hey, this works at home. I bet you it would work at the restaurant,
yeah,
too,
you get
right?
bored on certain ways you make fish. You just, you know, create different ways. Yeah.
Different things, right?
You know, my favorite is the next dish we're going to be doing.
Yeah. Oh, really, yeah?
Yeah, that's my
the
favorite.
The swordfish, yeah.
So did you create this dish?
No, my chefs.
Yeah.
A couple of chefs.
But it's definitely a homegrown one. I mean, this is from the restaurant.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what I love about it. And he has, I mean, the menu at this place is vast. I mean, vast.
Yes.
I mean, it's like a small book that you get.
Yeah.
But then the specials are, you know, I tell you the truth, you hardly even open up the menu because the specials are one of those things where you say, well, I'm crazy not to try that. You know, it's just terrific.
Yes.
And again, like a lot of people have been going there. I mean, of course, you get people from all over who come there, but a lot of people are the people, I mean, you've had customers for years and years and years, right?
Yeah.
Because when I go in there, it's like cheers. Everybody knows you're there. Everybody
knows
each other.
Everybody
knows
your name.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's really something,
it's
right?
True.
Yeah.
It's a nice thing.
I walked in there one night and there was a couple from Fire Island who have to drive off the beach or take the ferry off the beach and sitting at the bar having dinner. And I was kind of surprised to see them. And they said, no, we're here like at least once a week.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
So we got Asiago cheese.
Oh, that's nice too.
Okay, which I'm going to put on the top when it comes out. And then you just you spoon it into your spoon.
So back into the shells.
Yeah, back in the shell.
That's such an interesting thing.
Yeah.
Because it creates like its own little
You
know, bowl.
It's beautiful.
And also, by the way, it like that seems to be to me like a giant serving too. There's like a lot in there. Right?
Yeah, it's a lot. Yeah.
It's
yeah.
a lot.
Yeah.
Wow.
But you know, the squash is never consistent in size.
Okay, so you never really know, yeah, right?
Yeah, so you just, yeah.
Those are beautiful, though, right?
Something a little different.
Isn't that cool? That's
now, good. Does that head back into the oven? Is that the story with that?
Yep.
How does your oven?
The oven's at 400.
So it's a nice hot oven.
Yep.
All right, so he's going to put it in the oven. Why don't we let that cook for a second? We'll take a little break, and we'll be back with more real food right after this. Stick around.
The Catholic Faith Network Green Room was provided by Lane Office, your workspace built with integrity.
Boy, that just looks great. My Lord, that looks terrific. And I have to tell you, Frank, the aroma is just terrific.
Unbelievable.
It smells great, really. It's
unbelievable.
So fresh smelling and everything else.
So you roast in the oven for about, you know, 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Look how that comes out. That's so nice. It's
serve it in the restaurant.
Man, oh, man. And you can just see, like, the shrimp have cooked and everything is so colorful. I can't believe you use great colors in here, too. They're so alive looking, you know?
That's everything, yeah, everything's colored.
And then you top it with a little Asiago?
Yeah, little cheese.
Perfect.
Look how nice that is, boy.
Sprinkle a little basil.
Oh, and that's the best.
That's it.
Wow, look at that, huh?
Perfect.
What a great dish.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful dish.
Despite the fact that it's healthy,
and it's
delicious.
It's gluten-free.
Gluten-free.
And this dish we're doing now is gluten-free.
And this is pretty, I mean, and it's like zero carbs, pretty much. Just a tiny drop of carbs, maybe,
and you get the flavor you spice it up enough. If you little salt and pepper and... a lot of garlic and grated cheese.
I'll choose you for lunch. We'll see what happens.
Okay.
We'll see what happens.
Hearts are evens.
I know, right? This is great, though.
Thank you.
Now, what's going to be your next dish?
Okay, so this is a Long Island caught swordfish from a boat in Captree.
Tell us about that, because I think I've been on Long Island my entire life, and I just think of fluke and flounder for the most part when I think about fishing in the bay.
Yeah.
Where do the swordfish go?
We have along the coast, we have different species of fish. That's very delicious. And then you have the offshore people that go offshore, 80 miles, 100 miles.
Is that where the swordfish are? Are they further
swordfish off? They're 80 to 100 miles off,
and when you
1,000
catch
feet of water.
Like, how big is a swordfish when you catch a swordfish?
They go from, little babies up to 1,000 pounds.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And have you caught any big ones in your life? Or?
I caught 200-pounders.
Really?
300-pounders.
Really?
They're very hard to fight. I usually pass the rod. It's a lot of work.
It's a lot of work to get them in?
It's a lot of work.
And then, like... Can you butcher a swordfish? Like, you know how to pull it, get it all apart?
Sure,
really, yeah?
You gotta dress it when you first catch it. You gotta cut the head off and
bury
it in the ice.
And, now, what's the story with swordfish and mercury and all that stuff? Is it okay to eat it or what?
Does tilefish have a degree of mercury? Striped bass do, swordfish do.
Okay.
But it matters where the caught, if it's caught in South Florida, could be a difference the mercury content.
Okay.
In moderation. Isn't that
in
the
moderation,
key, really?
In moderation, it's okay, right?
Exactly.
I mean, generally, it really is my favorite fish, swordfish.
It's so delicious. If it's fresh, like this is.
Yeah, that, I mean, that looks great.
2 days ago.
And not a smell, not a drop coming out of it. It's terrific.
Yes.
So how do you start to prepare?
Okay, so we're gonna dredge it in a spice mix, which is.
So that's not breadcrumbs. That's a spice mix.
I used rice flour, whole wheat flour, a couple flours, and then I put paprika, granulated garlic, and Himalayan salt, and just a lot of different spices in there.
Now there's like a little red spot in the swordfish. Always
if,
is. You know?
If the red spot is large, the bloodline of the fish.
Uh-huh.
If it's large, you can take it out.
Okay.
This one's a small one.
So it's okay.
Yeah.
Can you eat that? Generally speaking,
I wouldn't eat it.
I don't eat it myself. I was going to say, but
it's very very small on this fish. I never seen it this thin.
Okay.
Maybe because of the way they bled it.
Okay. So it was just done the right way.
Yeah. Okay. So we're gonna do some red onion.
And I love
this. This is going to be cool. This is Livernaise.
Livernaise.
It's close to like Buttanesca. It's going to be with olives.
Yeah.
And some.
I don't want to keep saying my favorite, but this is my favorite way to have fish, too.
Yeah.
It's Livernaise.
Cool, yeah.
Like if somebody says to me, we can make it any way, I always choose Livernaise. That's my favorite way to have it.
Yeah.
I love it. Actually, this would probably be like one of my favorite dinners that you're making right now.
Yeah.
One of my favorite dinners is that you don't have to twirl. Put it that way.
Yeah. Okay. So we're going to do chopped green olives.
So. And then is that kalamatas you have there too?
These are kalamatas. Yeah.
Beautiful.
And then the olives, you know, if they're whole, you just give them a little whack with that and take the seed out. Nut out.
Now there are a number of chefs out there who would say it's better to have it like that because the olive's more flavorful with the nut in it. What do you think?
Yes, but it's a little tougher to eat.
And a big pain in the neck to knock all the middle out. I don't know.
Yeah.
Now, when you're doing this at the restaurant, are you doing it per order? Like, how do you do this, Frank?
Yeah,
you...
absolutely, per order.
Per order, really?
Yeah. So you can push this to the side, and then you can just brown your swordfish in here.
So then the fish goes in the same pan. So it's basically a one-pan preparation here?
Yeah.
That's wonderful, huh?
Make it simple. You get the flavors.
Oh, my God, that's incredible.
I'm sorry at home, everybody. You can't smell this, but it really does smell fantastic in here. That's beautiful. Great, great smell.
Yeah. So then at the end, I'm going to put a little basil chiffon on. So if you take all the leaves together, and you could take it and actually roll it, and you could chiffon on it.
Beautiful.
That I could do.
That you can do?
That I could do.
Well, I mean, listen,
so that'll be on top of it.
We should say that. You do a lot of cooking at home, I mean, right?
Not that much.
Well, I mean, you're out at events a lot, too. Yeah. We see each other on the circuit all the time.
Yes.
But, I mean, you still...
I do. I do. I like to cook.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good thing.
Okay, so I put a little vinegar peppers in here.
Vinegar peppers is great, too.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. And then usually at some point, tomatoes get in the game with Livernaise, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. And Long Island tomatoes.
Long Island tomatoes. Now, do you grow any tomatoes at home, Frank? I think with your life being what it is, I can't imagine how you could have time to garden.
I used to.
It's too tough, right?
A lot of work.
We do. Garden. We have them at home.
You put a little garden in?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
We do a lot of container gardening.
Cherry tomatoes. They have been so abundant this year. Yeah.
I always say they're prolific. There's millions of them everywhere. But around here, actually, on all the windowsills around Catholic Faith Network are herbs. And we're constantly growing herbs around here.
Yeah.
We have them all year round. I have some on the set, too, that grow all year round. Boy, that looks great. And that literally comes down and makes a beautiful sauce, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I love.
The longer you cook, you can throw a little wine in if you want.
Yeah.
But, you know, you do it at the end. Let it cook down.
We should mention, you brought some wine with you, Frank. What's the story with these wines?
Just a couple of wines.
Just some wine.
For you.
Because I know at some point, like you were actually doing some wine too, weren't you? At one point,
I was making a lot of wine. Yeah.
Yeah, right back in the day, right?
Yeah, my kids would help me.
Yeah,
girls would help me.
Like another family activity.
I was trying to get away from sulfites. So now you could buy NSA wines, which is no sulfite added.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And organic.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a lot better for you. You don't get the headache.
Oh, cool.
You know what the sulfites do to me? Sometimes I sweat. I don't know why.
Really?
But yeah, I said this to a doctor one time. He says, yeah, that happens. That's another symptom sometimes.
Oh, wow.
I used to get itchy over here.
Isn't that interesting? Yeah, it's crazy how that happens, right?
Yeah.
It's such a weird thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
Now, at this point in time, Frank, like with you being so involved, are you still like choosing the foods and stuff that you're buying from
Absolutely.
The purveyors? So you're still involved in all of that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I'm in the kitchen most of the time. I would love to be out in the dining room.
Yeah.
But I'm very picky on my kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
But, as far as buying and everything, yeah, we buy the best. We try to buy the best. But you can't fool Long Islanders, I'll tell you that.
I mean, but you're looking at these tomatoes, because I've seen you in action. Like, you're actually checking out the stuff you're purchasing. You're not just buying a case of stuff. You're looking at it, right?
Absolutely.
So it's like high-quality stuff all
returns,
the time, right?
We'll return items and things.
That's a good thing.
Why when you go there, it's consistent. And that's what you want in a restaurant.
It's a big thing in a restaurant,
know?
Right?
Yep. But it doesn't just happen.
No, I agree with you. It's absolutely true. You know, another thing I was thinking about you, Supervisor Carpenter, is that I know you've been involved, too, with a lot of our Catholic schools you help out, too.
We try.
It's a nice thing.
Yeah, we do. We do St. Mary's, you know, Our Lady of Lourdes, the school.
St. John the Baptist High School.
St. John's. I love St. John's. It's great. And, you know, talk about helping out. This gentleman here is no slouch when it comes to
stepping up,
there for the community.
Sure.
Not just the Catholic community, but anyone, anytime there's anything in town.
Yep.
You know,
they're always there.
For the restaurants to help out. Sure. I know the Chamber does a big event, a tasting event.
And, yeah, the tasting events. You know, I know you're a lot of those,
yeah,
too, right?
Yes, Frank is there.
Because I know St. John the Baptist has one. I saw you that one time, too.
Yes, because I see my customers.
Yeah,
And I give back to them.
Yeah, and that's a really nice thing, too. And I don't know if you've ever been to one of those events. That's one of those events, really, generally speaking, where they'll have a bunch of different restaurants, stores, and you go around and just taste a little bit from all of these places and see sort of the different things that they do. And you basically have a meal at this event.
Yeah, that's a great way of eating. Exactly. It's like eating a lot of appetizers.
Exactly.
Delicious.
Right.
Yeah.
But it's a great opportunity, you know, for a restaurant owner to show their wares and get people to have a little taste and get to meet you. And
Well, that's the other thing, too, is like even though you're in the back in the kitchen a lot, you still come out and say hi to people all the time. Because, I mean, I see you all the time.
I try, but once you come out for 5 minutes, it winds up being a half hour. So
that's how it always goes.
That's the way it is. Right.
So now this swordfish cooks pretty fast.
Yeah, it cooks fast. You don't want to overcook it.
And look at that.
Yeah. Oh, wow, that
and that,
awesome.
And my mouth is actually watering from the smell. The other thing that, like, olives cooking for some reason, capers cooking, that gets me. I love that.
Are there capers in here?
No, there's no capers in
this. No capers. You could put capers in.
But you could put capers if you want.
Absolutely.
But the olives just smell so great, too. And look at those dishes.
And they add that nice little touch of saltiness without a lot of salt.
Exactly right, which is
so you don't need no salt. I don't put salt there at all, just a little bit of black pepper.
Man, what a great smell.
Basil chiffon on the
middle. Oh, man, right?
Basil does it.
What do you think? You want to have lunch?
Sure.
This is a pretty good thing, man. This is great. All right, take me to lunch. I'll get the forks. We'll see you in a minute. We'll be back with more real food right after this. Does that look great or what? I know it's incredible. Really, really beautiful. You know, I was thinking about this during this. All of us, all three of us, are where we are because of, like, the good people who have supported us beforehand, you know? And you think about, like, your parents. You think about the people encouraged us along the way, you know? And you were saying that your mom hasn't been feeling so good in these days, right?
Alzheimer's. Started with dementia and Alzheimer's.
So
she doesn't know who I am anymore.
Oh,
yeah, it's a hard thing, you know?
But I try to bring back the Italian language to her and sparks her a little bit, but now it's to the point where she doesn't understand even the Italian much other than,
and I was saying to you, Frank, like I walked that road with my mom, you know, you remember that.
Absolutely.
And it's a heart-wrenching thing when our parents start that process, you know, particularly with dementia. I think it's just a hard thing, you know, because in an Italian family in particular, it's probably in every family, but, you know, we're all mama's boys, you know, and our mother's love. I was teasing at my mother's funeral. I said, if my mother could have taken the Blessed Mother out of the thing on the lawn, she would have put a statue of me if she could. I mean, you know, I will never have somebody more supportive. And I'm sure that was the same story in your life, too, right? Especially starting the business with her cooking with you, too, every day, right?
Yeah. I got to go back many years.
Yeah.
There's something beautiful about that.
1979 with her. You know, and I remember one day I yelled at her a little bit, and I felt so bad. I still remember that day.
You never forget, right?
Yeah.
But she doesn't want you to.
Yeah.
She doesn't want you to feel bad. A mom never wants you to feel bad.
Yeah. You know that song on the other side, right?
Yeah. No, and listening to the two of you, I only hope my kids say that about me. I have two sons.
Yeah, sure.
And I love them dearly, both of them.
Richie and Rob.
I'm very lucky.
Yeah.
Very lucky.
It's a funny thing, like I said. And I think there's a great, you know, desire in all of our lives to always give honor. I mean, not just because it's the 12, you know, 10 commandments, I mean, but in our lives, this is something that we want to do every day, give honor to our parents and the people who went before us, you know. So there's something great about that. And the great link is food.
Absolutely.
You know, I think that's the great thing because when, like, you know, even though these recipes might not have been what your mom made, necessarily at home when you were a kid growing up, but cooking, in a sense, gives Rana.
Yes. You know, mother used to always say, you get to somebody's heart with their belly.
That's the truth, right?
That's true.
Yeah, that's the truth. So it's kind of a great thing. So we pray for them. We pray for our parents.
Yes.
I had a beautiful prayer. I used to pray with my mom all the time in her life, and it's written by St. Ignatius. It's called Suscipe. You can look it up, S-U-S-C-I-P-E. And we prayed it every day, my mother and I. And the prayer goes like this. Take, Lord, receive all my memory, my understanding, my entire will. Give me only your love and your grace. That's enough for me. Your love and your grace, that's enough for me. Amen.
Amen.
I pray that with my mom every day, because what Alzheimer's does is it asks you to give over your memory, to give over your understanding to the Lord. But the promise after that is eternal life for you and for me. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Hey, if you want a recipe today, which I'm sure you do, you can email me at realfood@cfntv.org. We'll send you the recipes. And then, Frank, your website?
Francescosonline.com.
Francescosonline.com. You can't beat that. Angie, you?
You're everywhere. Islipny.gov.
And then take a look at what they're doing. She does a great job. Great. These are great, wonderful people of the community.
Thank you.
And Catholic people who really make a big difference. So we're glad you could be with us today. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time on Real Food.
Msgr Food and its brand Vantia are proud to support Real Food. Find Vantia cheese, cured meats, olive oil, and Italian specialty foods in your local supermarket, or email us at info@msgrfood.com for a list of retailers near you. Real Food set and appliances has been provided by Chufo Cabinetry, a family tradition of fine woodworking since 1907. Chufo Cabinetry has been filling the custom cabinetry needs of the New York tri-state area for over 100 years by combining old-world techniques with modern technology to provide the finest custom kitchens and millwork. Luxury appliance innovators Sub-Zero, Wolf, and Cove. Cosentino, a Spanish company world leader in the production and distribution of innovative surfaces for architecture and design. Silestone, Decton, and Sensa by Cosentino, technologically advanced surfaces that allow the creation of unique designs for the home and public spaces. Blackman Plumbing Supply. Visit a Blackman showroom today and let their specially trained design consultants help you find the luxury plumbing, tile, lighting, and stone products you need to make your project a success. Top Knobs, the designer's choice.